So if we're going to get out of debt, we probably need a plan, right? Hello everyone, John Gray here again, and today we're going to discuss how we're going to do it. How are we going to get out of debt? Well, it's called the Dave Ramsey Method, also known as the baby steps. Now, I chose this plan because Dave Ramsey himself was actually in a tremendous amount of debt. However, using components of this plan not only allowed him to get out of debt, but it also allowed him to create a tremendous amount of wealth for himself. So I'm going to take you through each step of the plan and then talk to you about how I'm going to be doing those steps just a little bit differently. So the first step is baby step one, and that is to save $1,000 in a temporary emergency fund. Now, a lot of you may be thinking, that's not enough money for an emergency. Now, I agree that a lot of emergencies could be much pricier, but I also understand Dave's intent in doing this. He believes that you'll be more likely to be aggressive in paying off your debts if you know you only have $1,000 to save you in case of an emergency. Baby step two is paying off your debt, but with a twist. During this baby step, you're going to stop all investing and all savings for retirement of any kind. Think of it as a temporary measure so that you can get your debt gone as quickly as possible. And here's how you're going to do that. Dave wants you to list all of your debt from smallest to largest, not counting your house, completely ignoring the interest rate. And he wants you to make minimum payments on all of them except for the smallest one. The tiniest one is the one you're gonna throw all of your extra money to and pay it off as quickly as possible. Now here's the important part. Once that debt is paid off, the money you're putting towards it goes directly to the next debt that you have in your list. That money does not go back into your pocket. There is no celebration. It just goes straight to the next debt. And you continue to do that until all of your debt is paid off. That's why this step is also called the debt snowball, because as you pay off your smaller debts, the money that you can actually put towards the larger debts continues to grow. Using this method allows you to feel like you're gaining momentum as you pay off the debt, and just like that, you're debt free. So that brings us to baby step three, which is beefing up that $1,000 emergency fund. You now want to save up enough money so that you have at least 3 to 6 months worth of expenses in that emergency fund. Now that may seem like a lot, but remember, you now have a bunch of money that's no longer wandering off going to pay off all those other people. So really, 3 to 6 months? Pretty easy. Now that brings us to baby steps 4, 5, and 6, which you're going to do all at the same time. Baby step 4 is to put 15% of your household income away for retirement. See, we're back to saving for retirement, but a lot more now because you can afford it. Baby step 5 is to start a college fund for your child or children, if you have children. Now, remember to take into account what type of school you think they're going to go to and where. Out-of-state and in-state tuitions are much, much different. And then there's baby step 6, which is paying off your house. Now, I'm going to live in an apartment, so this doesn't really apply to me, but that's like the granddaddy of all debt payments. Seriously, think about how much money you could save if you didn't have a mortgage. Man, you would have a lot of money. Don't let people fool you into thinking having a mortgage payment is necessary. It's not. Is it normal? Sure. But guess what else is normal? Being broke. So get rid of that stupid mortgage payment and then see how much money you have at the end of the month. There is one last baby step, which really isn't a step. It's more of a congratulations. It's baby step 7, which is build wealth and give, which you should be able to do a lot of now because you have a lot of extra money coming in that's not going to frivolous debt. And now you just live happily ever after and you don't worry about money anymore. So I'm pretty excited about going through Dave's plan, but I'm going to change a couple of things to make this work better for me. One of the first things you'll notice when you look into Dave Ramsey's method is that he expects you to never use credit cards ever again. You see, Dave Ramsey thinks about money management as being 80% behavior. And statistically speaking, people do spend about 25% more when they have plastic in their hand as opposed to having cash. So this is really solid advice for someone who has a lot of consumer debt. And if you know you're one of those people who has a spending problem when it comes to the credit card, Apple Watch, charge it, cut it up. But I don't have that problem. My only debts are my student loan and my car. And I've never ever paid interest on any credit card that I've ever carried. So instead of completely getting rid of my credit cards, I'm only going to use the one credit card that I have, and I'm only going to use it for bills that I'm already going to end up paying. The reason I'm doing this is because the credit card that I have gives me 1.5% cash back on any purchase that I make. So if the credit card company is going to give me free money, I might as well take it. The other thing I really don't like about Dave Ramsey's plan is the way he structures you saving for this emergency fund. As I mentioned earlier, $1,000 barely covers most emergencies, and I don't want to be in a position where I don't have the money if an emergency like that comes up. So instead of doing it in order, I'm going to combine baby steps 1 and 3 at the beginning of the process and right away save 3 to 6 months of expenses. Lucky for me, we already have that, so we're right on to baby step 2, which we're also doing a little bit differently. I take issue with the fact that Dave Ramsey has you list your expenses from smallest to largest and then pay them off in that order, regardless of the interest rate. In my opinion, that's the piece you should be the most concerned about, because it's going to determine how much you end up paying back that you didn't originally borrow. Let me give you an example. Let's say you have two credit card debts, one that's $9,000 and the other is $10,000. The $9,000 credit card debt carries an interest rate of 10%. While the $10,000 credit card debt carries an interest rate of 35%. What this means is on an annual basis, the $9,000 credit card debt is gonna cost you $900, while the $10,000 credit card debt is gonna cost you $3,500. On a monthly basis, that's $75 for the smaller one versus about $300 for the larger one. Now in Dave's plan, the smaller one gets paid first even though it's costing you a lot less money to have. He's not taking into account how much it's costing you every year. But under that model, I'm losing money by paying the smaller one first. Because of that, I'm going to flip the order. I'm going to list my loans from largest to smallest, and then from largest to smallest interest rate, because the ones at the top are the ones that are costing me the most money. Now again, Dave Ramsey's reason for doing it the other way is because he thinks about this as a behavior. A really large reason that people start paying off their debts but don't finish is because they see those large amounts and they get discouraged. Especially when they still have the same amount of loans out after 6 months because they've spent so much time paying off that big, large debt. If you do it the Dave Ramsey way, it makes you feel good about the little victories, giving you the momentum behaviorally to push through to the larger payments. But I'm looking at the overall goal here, and while it does give you momentum, the truth is that it can also cost you a lot of money if the interest rates on your larger debts are big enough. The other thing I'm going to do is give myself a little bit of fun money. The reason is very simple. If you cut yourself off from life completely and you don't give yourself any wiggle room, you're not going to stick to the plan very long. For my fun money, I'm going to take out $50 at the beginning of every month, and once it's gone, it's gone. This will keep me very aware of the limits that I have set for myself because the money that I have to spend is literally in my front pocket. No using credit cards for fun money. And any money from this left over at the end of the month goes back into my bank account and towards the debt. The only way I get to save fun money is if I have something that I plan to do already that's more than that $50 allowance I'm giving myself every month. But in those cases, I could only save $50 a month. So if something I want to do 7 months from now is going to cost me $200, I have to save 4 months worth of fun money if I want to do it when the time comes. My fiance is also getting $50 a month out of our household income. So if there's something we want to do together, we can also pull our money together if we need to. But basically, that's the whole plan. So what I encourage you guys to do is to try this with me and feel free to throw in the small changes that I suggested and let me know how they work for you. The next video is going to be all about the details of the budget and exactly how much debt we have to pay. I'm going to tell you now, it's about $51,000. Not very pretty. But we're going to do it, and in 2 years, it's going to be so worth it. Even if you don't do the Dave Ramsey plan, the point is to have a plan, do a budget, and to start. So thank you so much for watching and listening. Hopefully you got some useful information out of it. And I will see you guys in episode 3, the budget.